it makes me want to shout, to scream. It just makes me want to shout to know that God has us under his wings and has carried us through, and he's helping us to be able to become victors in every situation that we've encountered, especially for the last couple years. There's been some rough years for me. I don't know about you, but God, many are the afflictions of the righteous, but God delivers us out of them all. Isn't that what the word says?
Yes.
Isn't that what the word says?
Yes.
Amen. And I just thank and I praise God just for the opportunity. And I just bless my pastor and his wife for their absence this morning. And I'm just excited. I don't think that we could be living in a better time than what we're living in. Because regardless of what's going on, regardless of how the situation may look, well, how you say that, regardless of how it might smell, regardless of what people might say, regardless of what people might not say, God is in total control.
Amen.
And God has been impressing that up on me so lately that, every time I think about it, I get excited. Because sometimes when I know we're going through something, we wonder, well, what's going on here? But knowing that God is in complete control, we got to keep that in our minds. So right now, I'm going to ask everybody to stand as we just read briefly the word of the Lord. And I don't know, Habakkuk, he was a major, he was a minor prophet. And the only reason why they call him a minor prophet, there's several prophets in the Old Testament, and the major and the minor prophets. But the minor prophets are minor because the books are smaller. Not because of any stature, not because of any works they've done, but the only reason why they call him one of the minor prophets, his book was a little short. But even though his book was short, if you read Habakkuk, he was a powerful one. He was always, always asking questions. And God met him every time and answered. Amen? So let's see what Habakkuk is talking about this morning. The burden which the prophet Habakkuk saw, O Lord, how long shall I cry, and you will not hear, even cry out to you, violence, and you will not say, why do you show me iniquity and cause me to see trouble, for plundering and violence, and before me there is strife, contention arises, therefore the law is powerless, and justice never goes forth. For the wicked surround the righteous, therefore perverse judgment proceeds. Look among the nations and watch. Be utterly astounded, for I will work a work in your day, which you would not believe, though it were told you. I will stand my watch and set myself on the rampart and watch to see what he will say to me, and what I will answer when I am corrected. Then the Lord answered me and said, write the vision. Now hear this. Write the vision and make it plain on tablets, that ye may run who reads it. For the vision is yet for an approved time, but at the end it will speak, and it will not lie, though it tarry. Wait for it, because it will surely come, and I will not tarry. Behold the proud, his soul is not upright in him, but the just, but the just shall live by faith. Amen?
Amen.
Nothing happens. Well, we can get a benediction on that one. But the just shall live by faith. There's nothing more that I can say to that one. But amen and amen. And I thank and I praise God for his word today. And I'm just excited for those of you on Facebook and YouTube that are joining us this morning. Thank you so much for taking time out to worship the Lord with us this morning. And right now, I'm just going to say a little prayer. And God, we just ask that you would be with us all. God, that you would speak, that you would touch our hearts. And God, you know those who are going through hard places and hard times, God, having us to realize and stand fast on your faith, on the faith, knowing that all things are working together for the good, and knowing that faith is the substance of things hoped for, the evidence of things not seen. But because you said it, Lord, we believe it. And that's all that matters, God. And we thank you, we pray, you know, for those that you're healing, those that you're saving, those that you're delivering and setting free. In your son Jesus' name, you take control, God, because it's all about you. In your son Jesus' name, we pray. Amen. 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 Well, I just want to give you a little bit background here, what's going on in Habakkuk. Just like I said earlier, Habakkuk was one of the minor prophets. And Habakkuk, he was praying right here. He was calling out to God. And because the times were terrible. Just like I said, you have to kind of read the whole book of Habakkuk. I don't have time for that today, so you're going to have to read. And then you say, oh, wow, put turn that light bulb on. That's exactly what Reverend Marshall was saying. Amen? So Habakkuk was praying, calling out to God because the times were terrible. And you know, we might say that right now, that the times look a little rough sometimes, especially with the pandemic going on. I mean, like shootings. I mean, maybe I just have gotten crazy in the last couple of years. But you know what? I'm still determined to know that God is in control. And sometimes it just don't look like it. It does not look like it. But because the word says so, because it says that many are the afflictions of the righteous and God delivers them out of them all. And the word doesn't say some, but it said God will deliver us out of them all. And so we have to stand fast in his word, because that's why God put the word down here for us, is to begin to get in it, to begin to walk in it, to begin to eat it, to begin to talk it, to begin to encourage one another, and to begin to encourage ourselves. When all might look bleak, everything might be going nuts, we still have to know that God is in total control. Amen? And this wasn't the first time that Habakkuk called on the Lord. He was overwhelmed by what was going on in society. And how many of us can say, lately it's kind of been overwhelming about the things that's going on in society. But hold on. Help is on the way. And I do not only like to see help is on the way. Help is here. Because the word of the Lord lets us know that, like I said, the word right home. So it's time for you and I are to look and realize that God has everything under control. I think about that scripture in John, the 11th chapter, and it was the raising of Lazarus. You know, Jesus had gotten word about Lazarus was sick unto death. And then all of a sudden, you know, he kind of took his time getting there, as you and I might think he was taking his time. But then again, sometimes you guys, we gotta, my brothers and sisters, we gotta open up our spiritual eyes and see the whole picture and see that God is working it out no matter what it might look like. You know, in natural, if we look at things naturally, if it's red, the color is red, then it's red. And if the color is blue, then it's blue. And if the color is black, then it's black. But when it comes to the goodness and it comes to the miraculous deliverance and for God, ministry and undertaking for our need, the color might look red, but it can't be blue. The color might look black, but the color is orange. So we have to realize that just like when they told Jesus that Lazarus was sick unto death, I mean, as I was reading it too, it looks like Jesus was kind of dragging his feet, because think like he would have hurried over there and said, let me drop everything and do what I need to do. But you know, a lot of times when God, things are going on in our lives, that's when we kind of miss it. We kind of drop everything and try to go into it head on without waiting on God, without allowing God to lead it to guide us, without God to give us some direction in that path. And that's why we begin to veer off to the left or to the right, because we're taking our eyes off of Christ, because we're taking our eyes off of Jesus, the author and the finisher of our faith. And so when they told Jesus that Lazarus was dead, he said, I can just hear him saying, I know exactly what's going on. And then when he gets there, he says, as soon as Martha heard that he was coming, she said, Lord, if you had been there, my brother would have died. If you hadn't heard me, if you hadn't did it when I first asked you, I wouldn't be in it so deep. But a lot of times the reason why we're in it as deep as we are, because that's because we took our eyes off the Lord and we began to try to do it in our own self. But as long as we keep our eyes centered on God and realizing that come away, come what may, whatever it is that God has told us in his word, he's going to perform it until the day of Jesus. It's going to come to pass. And we need to get like a bull. You don't take a bull by the horns and say, if God said it, if scripture said it, if it's written in the word that God is going to deliver, if it's written in the word that God is going to heal my hurt, if it's written in the word that God is going to say, if it's written in the word that God is going to deliver, I don't care what it might look like.
Amen.
You know, there's one song that we always sing. I really don't care for the song. I know what the song is saying. And that's that song that says, he may not come when you want him, but he's right on time. I believe that God comes when we want him. And he's always on time. I was just hearing that with somebody the other day. If I'm in the middle of the river and I'm drowning, I know that God's able to raise me up if I drown. But when I feel that we're in the midst of the storm and all of life is raging all about us, I don't care how dark it gets, because sometimes it can get really dark. I don't care how dark it gets, but because God said in his word that no weapon that is formed against us will prosper, God said in his word that he would deliver us from all of our affliction, because it's in his word, because God put the word here for you and I to walk in it, to live in it, to eat it, and to begin to recognize that he is God. And above him, there's no other. And just like I'm sure when Jesus showed up, and Martha and Mary might kind of say, if he had been here before when we first called him, Lazarus wouldn't be alive. But if you read the John 11 chapter, it goes on to say that, you know, Jesus let it go the way it went so they can realize who he was. Because they can realize that he was the resurrection.
and the resurrection at the last day. And Jesus said to her, I am the resurrection. Wait a minute. I could just see him. You probably got a little like, wait a minute, mom. Excuse me. Do you know who you're talking to? Do you know who I am? I am that I am whatever you stand in need of. And he went on and told me, he said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me, though he may die, he shall live. So things get rough. So things get hard. You're going to come out on top because of who you belong to. Not who you are. Or not the way you want things to go. Or not how we think things should go. But because of whom we serve. And we serve a God that loves us with an agape love. A love that's unconditional. A love that loves us when we're lovely. A love that loves us when we're not so lovely. He loves us. And he said, whosoever lives and believes in and we shall not die. Do you believe this? Do you really believe that God is able to do the impossible? Because you know we have to remember that nothing's impossible with God. Amen?
Right.
We have to really begin to walk and to talk and to encourage one another. Because we're living a day and a time now. If we look at our surroundings, if we look up at things going, we will be deep down and depressed. But we as the children of the Most High God, our light's got to shine. Over Matthew 8 chapter, I think about gotta be a Habakkuk. We gotta know that we know. Because the last part was in the second chapter where it says, indeed, because he transgressed presence by wine. And he goes, he said, he's a proud man. Okay, I didn't jump too far. It says, write your vision. Write it down. What you want God to do today? Go home. Write your vision. Because if you write it down, you can look back and see what it is. When things get hard, you can see what it is. So write it down so you can see it. Write the vision. And make it plain. Make it plain. God, I want to be that person that you want me to be. I want to be that woman of faith, that man of faith that you want me to be, God. Write it down. Make it plain. And watch and see what he will say to me, and what I will answer when I am corrected. Then the Lord answered and said, again, write the vision, make it plain on tablets, that he may run who needs it. So if somebody reads it, they're going to get excited. If sister, if deacon is there, go write something down, and I happen to see what she wrote down, see all the goodness of God that she wrote down, I want to be able to get excited and say, if he did it for Deacon Zephyr, then he'll do it for me. If he did it for Minister Jones, he'll do it for me. If he did it for Sister Wanda, he'll do it for me. Amen? He said, for the vision is yet for an appointed time. So that's why we got to write it down and read it over and over and over again to begin to get in our spirit. So we begin to forget what's going on around us. So we begin to forget that, you know, how things are, but what things will be according to faith, knowing that everything that you write down or we write down on our tablets, asking God to bless, asking God to minister, asking God to heal. You know, there's some of us that have businesses that we've been sitting on for too long. You better write that business down and put it in on a tablet and get going and let God bless you. It's time to realize that God is in total control. And we as the people of God ought to be leaders regardless of what's going on in the world. Amen?
Yeah.
And he said, he will say to me, and I will answer. I can't see these glasses. Though it tarries, wait for it. So it may take a little while longer. And I know one of the hardest things for us to lose weight. Amen?
Yeah.
I know sometimes I pray and I feel God say, wait, not yet. Okay, God, I feel like a little kid. Okay, God, when, God, when are you going to do it? And write it down. Read it daily. Claim it daily. I'm going to be a mighty woman of God. I'm going to be a mighty man of valor. I'm going to touch the sick, and they're going to be recovered. I'm going to pray for those that are going through, and they're going to find deliverance. Write it down. Make it plain. Begin to live it. Begin to walk it. Even before it comes to pass, because it says right here, it might be a little while. You might have to tarry and wait on God when it comes to pass. Because he goes on to say, wait for it, because it will surely come, and I will not tarry. Behold, the proud, his soul is not upright in him, but the just shall live by faith. Amen.
Amen.
And just like I said, time out, y'all. Time out, y'all. It's time to step back and realize that God is in complete, total control. Amen. It's beginning to be a Habakkuk. Go to God. God, what are you going to do? It's all right. But you know, sometimes I've all often said that I'd rather be crazy and kooky and going through with God. With God.
Amen.
Than without God.
Yeah.
Amen.
Yeah.
And I'm sure Habakkuk, you know, some when I was reading, I'm like, who are you to ask God when and how and when come and why not? We're allowed to. But we just gotta hold on. We gotta hold on and know that the just shall live by faith. Amen.
Yeah.